All right, in this video, we're going to have a look at the XDJ RX 2 and my thoughts on it. Well, probably a lot of people already know my thoughts on it. But I think with this video, if you're in a position where you've got a wad of cash and you're thinking about buying some kit, then I would like you to consider the RX or the RX 2, which is in front of you. Now, underneath this, okay, this is the crazy thing, and what I'm about to say can be backed up, because if you've watched gig logs or, you know, you see quite a few of my videos, I'm using the RX, but underneath here is the DJM 900 Nexus 2 there, and a couple of CDJ Nexus 2s, the 2000s. So, you know, each one of those items is worth more than what's on top of them. Okay, don't panic, there are deck savers on the kit, so nothing's going to get scratched. But I still like to use the RX. If I go out to a gig, I will take the RX with me. Even though the kit underneath is, I'm not saying is far superior, but maybe there are more features. I like the RX 2 because it's all in one. You haven't got to mess around with different flight cases. But having said that, okay, if let's say I was going to a club night or I was arranging my own sort of club event, for example, you know, I've done a few festivals, I would take the RX definitely as a backup. But of course, I would use the Nexus series. I'd be an idiot to take the RX 2 to, let's say, a big dance event and expect top DJs to play on it in front of thousands of people. Even though they could, it still can be done on most riders now. If the DJs haven't got separate CDJs and a separate mixer and they turned up with a venue that can house 1,000 people and saw the RX in front of them, they'd probably walk out, because it's not the industry standard for, let's say, huge nightclubs. On the other hand, it's great, let's say, if they're in the hotel room with a bottle of Dom Perignon next to them and they want to have a bit of a tinker prior to their set. Of course, they'd be quite happy to use the RX. So, why do I like it so much? It's got everything you need. It's got the footprints of pretty much the high-end Pioneer kit. Okay, it's just two-channel, but guess what? You've got a third one over here. So, for example, let's say you've just got, I don't know, someone, like, shoves an iPod in front of your face during a gig, says, can you play this tune? It's my favourite. Well, instead of telling them to bugger off, of course you can if you want to. All you got to do is go to the auxiliary in, and there's your volume control. You've got a trim there. Okay, you've got no bass, mid or treble there, but at least you do have a third input. And also, let's take it to the next dimension. You've actually got four channels here, because you can use, well, in fact, actually thinking about it, you've got five, I do beg your pardon. There's actually five ways of playing audio through this, because you can also use the microphone input. So all you need to do is make sure you've got the correct connections with the microphone. That would be an XLR or jack. Slightly more intricate, because you don't want to start, you know, if you're not completely familiar with how to set up this correctly, I wouldn't go there. But of course, the people in the know will understand that you've got deck one here, deck two there, you've got deck three on your auxiliary input, deck four on one of the microphones, and deck five on the other one. So guess what? Five channels, if you really think about it. Now, that's insane. That's absolutely insane for something like this that costs less than a CD player. And if you bought a CD player that would cost you more, you've just got a CD player and that's it, nothing else. So what else have we got with the RX2 that's interesting? Right, okay, so again, it's touch screen. You've got a shortcut button here that can take you to a QWERTY keyboard, or alternatively, you can set parameters, for example, your settings, hot cue, If you want to use quantize, you can set the beat value of quantize as well. So let's say, for example, I don't know, you want to form a loop and you're not sure about if your finger is going to be snap on in time. Well, of course, if you set quantize, let's imagine you start the loop accidentally a fraction of a second before that beat and a fraction of a second after the beat. So you want to do one bar loop using quantize, that will snap it into time for you. And again, I highly recommend you use the Rekordbox software, even though this track hasn't, do apologise, because once you use Rekordbox with the RX2, everything comes to life. It's almost like, you know, someone is stuck inside and they need to be outside to get the full life of them. You know, this particular person has been stuck inside for years. They're a moany old bastard. And guess what? As soon as you bring them outside, they become a happy, lovely person, full of life, with a big smile on their face. That's exactly what will happen with this player. Stick Rekordbox in it, and it will smile at you and give you a big kiss. Right, so get a menu. We've got the QWERTY keyboard. I'm just going to go back. We're on search here. So let's go to folder, which we are anyway, or we were. Get a karmic power, Lord hear our prayer, bang, put it on, press play, and away you go. All right, now again, this video as well is maybe targeted DJs who do not know much about the RX2 and are thinking about getting a player. So at the moment now, I'm on USB number one. Now you always know which USB you're playing from simply because that USB will be flashing. So I can, if I want to, I can press the button below USB 2. Now the LED that was highlighted in red has gone. That gives me the opportunity now of unplugging my USB. Small point here, but very valid. It's exactly the same as, say, using a computer. Once you put your USB, also known as the thumb drive, in your computer, you finish doing whatever you need to do and you pull it out. That's not a good idea because the computer may over time stop recognizing the USB. You always need to eject. So it's exactly the same with this. Do not pull it out. Just press the button so the RX2 understands that, yes, that has now been ejected. And then, of course, you can pull it out. Now, also, what is great with the USB 2, if you have a thumb drive, not in one, but in USB 2, you can not only play from that, but you can actually record to the USB 2 as well. All right, so it's a great feature. Now, something else that is an effect, but not an effect, and it's one of my favourite, is the slip mode. Now, again, this video is targeting people who have no idea what slip mode is. Let's imagine you want to do a spin back. So I'm going to go forward a bit. Let's go in disengage slip mode. This, by the way, Eddie Amador, Lord Hear Our Prayer from Karmic Power Records. There'll be a link in the description to this track. So let me do a spin back. Okay, so what's happened? I've spun back. So the track has literally spun back. And then wherever the spin back stops, that's where the track will start again. So if you're, let's say, doing a mix and you want to do a little spin back, if you did that, you'd have to be very clever to make sure you snap it in beat and in phrase and in time. On the other hand, if you engage slip mode, you can spin back forward as much as you want and the underlying track will carry on playing at the same time signature it was prior to you spinning back. So, same as a hot cue. Got my finger on the hot cue. Keep finger on the hot cue, it'll go from that point. Take my finger off, it will snap back to where the track should be playing anyway. Now, this is something here that is very, very important, especially for the new DJ who hasn't got the foggiest, is your tempo select. You've got plus or minus 10, 16 or wide. Now, if you're new to DJing and let's say you're finding it difficult to beat match, highly recommend to stick to plus or minus 6%. It means you've got more control over that pitch. So for example, an easy way of explaining it, if your track you're playing is a bit of hip-hop, 100 BPM, at plus or minus 6, bring the pitch all the way towards you, you have now increased it to 106%. On the other hand, if I move the pitch all away from me, I've now decreased it by 6%, which means that track will now be 94 BPM. So if you just use that logic, then guess what it is at 10, 16, and 100. Now 100 is slightly different because 100 will mean that you will increase the speed 100% or stop it. So have a listen. Bang, stopped. Now the wide is not a good idea, especially if you're trying to mix one track into the other. It can be done, it is possible, but it is very difficult. Now the wide feature is great for effects. So, you know, maybe you want to get some kind of really dreary or interesting sort of beginning of a mix. That can be achieved by making sure master tempo is selected and I am going to put the pitch down to like minus a lot. Press play, here we go. Ah, guess what? Let's put it on wide to begin with. Right, so there, here we go. There. Now, with master tempo disengaged, it's going to sound completely different. Check it out. Now, master tempo just keeps the key, the pitch of the track, the same, no matter where you move the pitch control. Okay, now without confusing people, we have hot cues, we have beat loop, we have slip mode, and we have beat jump. Now again, what I want to do with this video is show you, let's imagine now, let's take this on board. Let's say you're a brand new DJ, and you're not familiar with loads of effects and the ins and outs of, you know, wacky transitions. All you want to do, you want to get something that you can open the box, you can look at, you have a certain amount of an idea of sort of, well, I know what DJing is, I know the bass, mid and treble, and oh, the up faders, I know what they do, and the crossfade. So you want to be able to open the box, plug it in to the mains, plug it into your speakers, and pretty much start to mix. Well, this video is going to show you that. All right, so again, two channels, you've got your headphone here, you have got these two dials here, the sound color effects, for small effects. Now, we've got dub echo, sweep, noise and filter. Now, the sweep is a great effect because what it does, it like really chops up the tune. So we're going to sweep. You know, we've almost got now, from a house tune, we've got like a techie track. Now that, to me, that's amazing, you know? It's not doing much. It's almost like, it, you know, you imagine you sat there or stood up and all of a sudden someone chops away your middle, so you've got your head left and your legs. That's pretty much what's happening here. It's taking away that kind of mid and just giving you that kick and the high end. Love it, absolutely love it. Now at the top, above each of the channels, you've got three choices. You've got deck, line and phono. So at the back, I did say in a previous video, I was incorrect that there's only one input. There's actually two inputs. So you do have an input for your line as well as your phono. So phono, of course, vinyl turntable. Line is auxiliary in, for example, separate CD player, whatever you want, so long as it does have auxiliary, also known as AUX, AUX or line input. Next one is deck. So we're on deck as well. and over to deck two, same exactly on the left-hand channel. Something here that one person I teach in my online lessons mentioned about, which is the vinyl mode. Now, they were concerned that when they played a track, it was always jumping, it was shuddering when they were in pause mode. And that was because they were in what's known as CDJ mode. And it's entirely up to you if you want to do this, but if you hear that, now this is CDJ mode. Now this to me would be the most annoying sound in the world. This would be like going to the dentist and having the dentist just drill one tooth constantly with no stopping. I hate, personally, oh, this to me is a nightmare. Go to vinyl mode, it stops. How about that? So just make sure you've got vinyl mode engaged. Now that turntable will act exactly, well, not exactly, but pretty much like a vinyl turntable. That's what you want. So just make sure, to begin with, you're in vinyl mode. Everything's fantastic. Now again, if you can't mix perfectly, so let's imagine a brand new person, you want to be a DJ, you know what to do, but you can't beat match. Guess what? You do have the option of syncing the two tracks up, again, so long as you use the Rekordbox software. You can either have the right-hand side master, the left-hand side sync, alternatively, the left-hand side master, the right-hand side sync. All you have to do is press the master on the right or the master on the left, and that's pretty much it. The one side will beat match with the other one. Again, that's not going to happen at the moment because this track is not has not gone through Rekordbox. Some people always ask me, what's the tap button for? Well, if you're playing a track, tap along to it, and then that will manually then get the timing of your tapping into these effects here. So, very quickly as well, this area from top to bottom, we've got booth monitor. Now, again, this is what makes this player a little bit more special from the other, let's say, cheap and cheerful controllers, is because that dial there will let you add on an external set of monitor speakers. So if you do, let's say, take this to a medium-sized gig, you know, you can have your own little PA system there. You can change the volume of the PA system that you've got, and you won't interfere with the master volume, which is, of course, dead centre, just below the screen, on the RX2. Now, if we go below the booth output, we've got beat effects, we've got an arrow facing the left and one facing the right. And that will just increase or decrease the amount of effect based on the right button will increase, the left one will decrease. Below that, we've got delay, echo, spiral, reverb, trans, flanger, filter, pan and roll. And then below that, we can select what we want the effect to be on. Now, not many people do this, all right? But give it a go. Try it. Why don't you put the effect to mic, microphone, and just say something in the mic and get an effect over your voice. It's fun. Believe me, it's fun. Right, what else can I tell you about this? Yeah, we you know, we've got two channels here, so we can have two microphones. And you've got EQ on the mics as well. Just bass or low and high, but you've still got EQ, which is great. We can add loops. So, for example, all right, that's slightly off. Okay, it is slightly off, but never mind. All right, so I'm just going to press the out. I'm going to move the jog wheel anti-clockwise. Okay. Okay, all right, not brilliant, but you know, I mean, you could actually use this as some kind of keyboard. Now, all I did there, I went to, made sure the pitch was on the wide feature, and I disengaged master tempo, and now I can make some wacky sounds. The deck is queued up. All I'm doing is tapping the cue button. Okay, so let's take this to the next level. See, we've got that on pitch. See, I've made that sound even higher. Filter. You see, this is what a lot of DJs don't do. Trust me on this. What they will do is they will look at, let's say, the sound color effects and use one of those. Or maybe they will use one of the effects over this side. Or maybe they'll form a loop or something like that. What most DJs do not do is use the grey matter and think, well, how can we like mix everything together? You know, add this effect with that effect and do some kind of effect on the deck. That's exactly what I've done there. That's what you need to do. Doing something like this, correctly, of course, unlike me, well, it'll just put you at another level. All right, so what else can I tell you about the RX2? Now, again, this is happening with a lot of players today. It's something very small, but it's great. On the front left-hand side, you have two inputs for your headphones. Now, if we look at old-school, well, not old-school mixers, but even going back a couple of years, you would only have a quarter-inch jack input. Now, of course, people have thought, these crazy people from Pioneer and a couple of other companies are going, well, you know what? Why don't we just add another headphone input? But of course, the mini jack. So it means if you do forget your quarter-inch jack, dim problems, as we say in Wales, no worries, because you can just plug it in. But also, think about it. That's two inputs. Guess what? That means two DJs. It's great for me, because when I teach people here, I can have some headphones plugged in and listen to the DJ I'm teaching. And of course, they can do a mix and I can tell them whether they're out or not. All right, so all in all, this player is pretty much all you need. Now, again, very quickly as well, something just to make sure you know what you're doing before you think there's something wrong with my headphones. We've got the headphone level there. Now, this is the same with most controllers. Okay, make sure that you understand what the headphone mixing dial is for. Really important, because let's say, for example, that dial is anywhere from the Q up to, well, it shouldn't really be at master. Let's say it's in between the Q and it's sort of, I don't know, facing 9 o'clock. And you can't understand why you've only got the Q button highlighted on the right hand side, but you seem to be able to hear what's being played on the left hand side. Now, that's because this dial will mix in the other sound from the other side. So if you only want to hear the one side that is queued up, just make sure that the headphone dial is set to the Q position, which is the off position, which is at 7 o'clock. And that is exactly the same across the board with pretty much any sort of controller, or for that matter, any mixer. Because as soon as you turn any dial at all to the 7 o'clock position, you've turned it off. All right. So only a small bit of an insight there. Now, again, I did say earlier, and I need to clarify this, if you use Pioneer, then the RX2 comes to life. There are so many more features to this. There's too many to explain in this video because I have not got the next 6 months. Pioneer recently now have brought out an extra part to, to Rekordbox, where you can use the Rekordbox software to do your light show. Stunning. Also, what you can do with Rekordbox now, again, I do believe it's a paid add-on, but you can now get text while a track is playing. Now, I do believe there's a third party involved. Don't quote me on that, but, you know, that's pretty good. So, for example, you know, you're playing a track, you do have a television screen, or you've got a projector. You can have imagery on there, and you can have the wording from the track. So guess what? People can sing along to it. Imagine that. Mobile DJ, hey Macarena. Say no more. All right, now, if you want any more information on the RX2, what I suggest you do is, after this video, just have a look on YouTube and look at some more videos. There'll be there's hundreds out there, more in depth on what it can do, what it can't do. But finally, let's finish on this. Now, I truly believe that the days of your controllers, now that I'm pretty sure on this, pretty sure, the days of having a controller and having a cable into a laptop are numbered, because I always hear about people saying, oh, the laptop's crashed or this, or there's been a problem. You know, you've got a weak link, and that weak link is the USB cable. Now, what I'm pretty sure will happen, maybe in the next 5 years or slightly less, we will get to the stage where we'll have controllers like this that will do everything. And if any companies are listening to this now, this is what I this is the way you should go, seriously. And if you believe me, give me a thumbs up, and in a comment, just say, I like what you're saying at the end of this video, and add your bit to it, because companies may watch the video and may also look at the comments and get your ideas as well. But this is what we need. We need a controller like this, of course, touchscreen. A bigger screen, so of course, all the information can be on the screen on the controller. No need for a laptop. Also, you have USBs, so you can plug your USBs in. More importantly, what you've got is you've got some form of internal SSD, a solid state drive, or any form of large capacity storage. So, for example, you know, you could have two inputs that you can put your own storage in, a minimum of 1 terabyte each. So then there's no need for any form of external unit. And again, for firmware updates and whatnot, just do it via USB. So what you have got then is you've got an all-in-one unit that does everything. No need for your laptop. You haven't got to wait for the laptop to, you know, boot up. Everything's on here. The software's on here. Your storage is on here. You're pretty much good to go. You make that 3 or 4 channels, wow, that would sell like virgin hotcakes. Right, now then, like I said, go and check out more. This is the Pioneer XDJ RX2, and I think it's shit hot. Practice and enjoy. Thank you very much.